Gina Lee Davis. This is a short warm-up for kind of our Women's Fast Pitch League, 18 and up, if you show up right before game time. And it really helps to do this to prevent injury. If you only have about 10 or 15 minutes, this is a great thing to do. I first want to go for a jog about football length away and back, just to get the blood flowing and loosen up all the joints. Feeling extra tight that day, or it's been a while since you've moved your body. Right after you run, you want to go into a movement warm-up versus a static stretch where you're just standing and holding something. So you want to keep your blood flowing and stay loose. So I usually go right into this one. It's a really common movement that you're going to do. It's kind of like running, but an exaggerated form of it. I like to focus on toes to the sky and always coming down on the balls of the feet. You can go about 5 to 10 yards. Again, we got here late. We've only got a few minutes to warm up. Toe to the sky. Getting a good flex here. Coming down on the balls of your feet versus the heels. It's just an athletic thing to try and get in muscle memory. Toe up, toe down. Next one, you can go heel to butt. Just very common movement, just like running, but an exaggerated movement. You don't want to take your knee here, kind of keep it straight down to get a good pull through the whole quad. It's real common for women who haven't played in a while and don't do a proper warm-up to pull. See, my balance is off, so you want to think about core. Having good control of your body. Another good one, I'll back up here for a good view. Stretch out the outer hip, pulling the shin, not the foot, so you're putting stress on the ankle. Good, again, balance, squeeze the core, focus on control of the body. When I teach young girls, a lot of parents want me to teach them how to pitch or hit, and I have to go to this because there's a real lack of body control in athletes, young and old. Same thing, always coming down balls of the feet. Okay, keep the feet moving. That's another common one I like to do real quick is maybe a forward lunge. Nice big step, elbow to ankle, right into the next one. There's a lot more of these you can do. These are just a few of the main ones that really get you a good stretch to prevent injury, mainly for that first sprint out of the box. That's a lot of times when girls will pull one of these muscles here, or a hamstring. Hey, bud. Okay, after this, it's almost game time. You want to get a couple really quick twitch muscles. So I like to go to high knees. Always focus on good arm movement, hips to lips. Again, this is like quick twitch. Come out of it, you can go backwards. Knees up, belt high. Come out of it. Couple deep breaths in the nose, out the mouth. Whew. Another good common one in softball to go to is the side shuffle. Getting a good athletic position to start. Right here. And back, both ways. Common thing here, good thing to focus on just to be more athletic, not letting your lead toe get out like you're like country dancing. Keep those toes straight ahead, nice and athletic, quick twitch muscles. Last one I'll go from there is like a sprint. Maybe a, like a lead off to a sprint. So, quick lead off, turn and go. This is a full sprint. So you do at least 2 to 3 before you actually do one in a game. I'm pretty breathed, so that was only maybe like 5 minutes or so. Anyway, I feel like I'm ready to